Finally, a Sarkhan left unattended can pose a lot of problems, and the opponent here is about to find out just what that looks like.
And yes, look at this. This opponent, no respect. It has no respect for Sarkhan of Fireblood whatsoever, going after the life total of our hero, Super Mad Lad, very aggressively. And he's going to pay the ultimate price here.
Absolutely. He's going to dig up every dragon he can possibly think of. And he might just break arena doing it as all those little sweet legendary animations play all at the same time.
Let's have a look at exactly what Mad Lad's working with here. Oh wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 1, 15, 1 squillion billion here. All of these dragons. And choosing to put double Lathless into play despite the legend rule. Just for S's and G's. My goodness me, what a baller.
A bold move, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off for him.
Well, it's going to pay. Well, one thing it's not going to pay off for is the GPU of his computer, because, oh, Dennis, these animations. Oh my goodness, look at this.
Oh my God, wrecks his computer and his opponent in one fell swoop. Riley, sometimes in Magic you'll deal with an issue or, you know, send something away, and you think that's going to be the end of it, but that's not always the case.
Certainly not, Dennis. And in this situation, we're going to see here. Well, look. An important threat, a robust threat. It's a 2-1 in Legacy. When you're on one life, you need to get rid of that any way you can. But tucking it away when your opponent has Thought Scour? Ugh.
Not the best, absolutely not. He draws it instantly, casts it instantly, doesn't even need to flash anything back, and just presents the end of the day for his opponent. That is brutal.
So the Teferi was 5 mana. This Planeswalker comes into play with 1 loyalty.
Yeah.
It did stone cold nothing.
We have an elaborate version of the Monty Hall problem here, Riley, and a fun game that Mike Sigrist likes to call How Many Hollow Ones Could I Possibly Have in My Hand?
Yes, the famous Brad Nelson impersonator here. Look, you've seen this before. Yep, Burning Inquiry, turn one, discard randomly, put 3 Hollow Ones in play, snore, who cares? We've seen it all before, but there is a twist in the tale here, Dennis.
Absolutely. So Luke's teammate actually is going to reach over and pick some cards away, and he hits the jackpot, dings away. Double Hollow One, exactly, because playing those 2 Hollow Ones would have been pretty bad for Luke. And then Siggy's going to pick a couple of Luke's cards, send them to the bin as well. And then you would think Mike's out of gas now.
That's it. I mean, the 2 Hollow Ones have hit the bin. He's got nothing left. Oh, look at that sneaky peek in the hand. Here's 1 Hollow One and the second one as well. So just a 2-2 split across the board here.
That's absolutely brutal. Riley, sometimes in a complicated game, in a complicated board state, it's important to just take some time, and especially during your opponent's turn, to think about what you want to do.
Yes, Dennis, and then also there is Kick Fight with Fire that means all of your Rain Man-like mathematics can render you... And look at this. Day 9 knows exactly what he sucked up here. This poor bugger. Oh, no.
Poor Sean just walks right into that.
I mean, all of the numbers floating around his head like that scene in Hangover, it wasn't doing him any good. Fight with Fire to the face. Get you dead, mate.
Speaking of Rain Man-like mathematical skills, Riley, you're going to need some for this next clip.
Yes, indeed. Look at this. All I can see, Dennis, is the double copy of Ajani's Welcome, meaning we're going to see more triggers than a firearm repair shop here with... his opponent's on 12, attacking for... is it going to come together?
It just keeps coming. The triggers just keep coming. His opponent almost times out, clicking through just resolve over and over again.
And here, I mean, if the opponent has anything, surely this attack isn't going to get through. Maybe line up some blocks. On 8 life, you'd think they're probably going to be fine here, right?
You'd think so, but that Epicure of Blood and all those little lifelinking cats add up to, in this case, exact season. It's going to be one hell of a story to write home about for Graham and James.
Oh, no. Titanic Growth's fine. No. Look, Titanic Growth, they can stabilize. They're on 3.
Just when you thought there was no more triggers, they pull you back in.
Exactly. I love the exacties as well. Very, very satisfying.
Thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. If you have your own submissions to MTG Top 5, either tweet them at us with hashtag MTG Top 5 or email them in to submissions@channelfireball.com.